we will solve some problems regarding the third chapter. First problem, the storage battery of a car has an EMF of 12 volts. If the internal resistance of the battery is 0.4 ohm, what is the maximum current that can be drawn from a battery? Okay, so very simple problem. One car battery is that. A car battery EMF anna kottidare given EMF of the battery that is equal to 12 volts and the internal resistance of the battery is given small r is equal to 0.4 ohms. Okay, we have to calculate what is the maximum current that can be drawn from the battery. A battery in the maximum is to current anna draw madabodu antheli. We know a simple expression for current when a battery is connected to an external load capital R. Now that I is equal to so EMF divided by capital R plus small r. That formula we know. Capital R, it is the external load, and small r obviously the EMF of the cell. Now the current is said to be maximum if capital R is equal to 0. The value of the external load is 0. That means when the external load is disconnected, we can draw a maximum current from the battery. So if this is the case, then I maximum is equal to, it is simply EMF divided by the internal resistance of the battery after that. So therefore, very simple is that. So EMF is 12 volts. And this one internal resistance is 0.4, or this is equal to, now I can write this one as 120 divided by 4. Calculation is easier to tell. Therefore, the maximum current that we can draw from this battery is 30 amps. This much amount of current can be drawn from the battery. So the simple thing is, maximum current is possible only when the external load is 0, or that is open circuit. Simply we can say that it is when the circuit is open, the maximum current can be drawn from the battery is 30 amps. Next problem, a battery of EMF 10 volts and internal resistance 3 ohms is connected to a resistor. If the current in the circuit is 0.5 amps, what is the resistance of the resistor? What is the terminal voltage of the battery when the circuit is closed? Now that is the problem. For that one, we will write a simple circuit. Now this is a battery. Here we are having with an internal resistance. Now this is the internal resistance of the battery. Okay, now it is connected to a load, an external resistor. Now this is the simple circuit. A battery of EMF is given, that is 10 volts, and internal resistance is given of 3 ohms. Now it is of 3 ohms. It is connected to an external resistor capital R. Now we have to calculate what is the external value of the external resistor, and also given then the current starts to flow in the circuit. So the direction of the current is as shown in the figure. Now the current is given, if I take it as I, some current I, its value is also given 0.5. that is a simple circuit. Okay, now given solution, solve here. Now given, now EMF of the cell is given, therefore EMF is equal to, so it is 10 volts. Internal resistance is given, small r is equal to 3 ohm. When the circuit is connected, current starts to flow. That current is given, current is equal to 0.5 amps. Now what we are going to calculate? We are going to calculate what is the external load resistor. And what is the terminal voltage? That means when the current starts to flow, what is the voltage drop across the load resistor or the terminals of the cell? Terminals of the cell alli eshtu voltage drop aagutade heli. Very simple ide. We are familiar with the expression for EMF. So EMF is equal to the current into sum of the two resistors. One is the external resistor and another one is the internal resistor. That formula we know. So therefore, substituting the values, then we have to find what is the value of R. So R we can simply write R plus R is equal to E by I, or R is equal to E by I minus small r. That is the formula we are getting. Now EMF, it is 10. Now current is 0.5 minus 3 ohm. Now 10 by 0.5, or I can write it as 100 by 5. So 100 by 5 madidre I will get 20 minus 3. Therefore R is equal to 17 ohms. This is the value of the external resistance. Okay, very simple. Now we have to calculate terminal potential, terminal voltage. Now we are familiar with the definition of EMF as well as terminal voltage. EMF is, it is the voltage or potential difference across the terminals of the battery when the circuit is open. That means when no current is flowing, that we know. Now we have to calculate terminal voltage. Terminal voltage, it is the potential difference across the terminals of the battery when the circuit is closed. That means when the current starts to flow. Now we have to calculate what is the potential across this resistor. Now that can be calculated by using the Ohm's law relation. It is simply the product of current and that resistor. Now current, they have given, it is 0.5. And the resistor, value of the resistor, just we have calculated, it is 17. Therefore, this one is equal to 0.5 and 17. If you multiply, I will get 8.5 volts. 8.5 volts. Now, look here. We are applying 10 volts to the circuit. But across the resistor, we are getting 8.5 volts. So, that is the difference between the EMF and the terminal voltage. So, 10 volts and apply martha idivi. But across the load resistor, we are getting 8.5. 1.5 volts L by 2. So it is dropped across the internal resistance. So 1.5 volt in akta, it is dropped inside the cell because of the internal resistance. Clear? Next problem, three resistors 1 ohm, 2 ohm, 3 ohm are combined in series. What is the total resistance of the combination? Part B, if the combination is connected to a battery of EMF 12 volts and the negligible internal resistance, obtain the potential drop across each resistor. So more resistor kottidan. Three resistors 1 ohm, 2 ohm, 3 ohm are combined in series. What is the total resistance of the combination? Part B, if the combination is connected to a battery of EMF 12 volts and the negligible internal resistance, obtain the potential drop across each resistor. So more resistor kottidane, more resistor resistance is given, 1 2 3, equivalent resistance anna find out madodu. Then if a battery of 12 volts is connected, then what is the potential drop? First we have to calculate what is the current flowing through the circuit, and then we have to calculate potential drop across the three resistors. Now let me write the diagram. We have first resistor is connected in series with the second, and it is in connected in series with the third resistor. Now simple is that this is 1 ohm and this is 2 ohm and this one is 3 ohm. Now what is the equivalent of this one? So given, we will list out what are the given things. So let me take R1 is equal to 1 ohm and second resistor R2 is equal to 2 ohm and third resistor R3 is equal to 3 ohms. That is given. Now what is their equivalent? Since they are connected in series, I will write their equivalent as RS. RS is the equivalent resistance. If they are connected in series, the equivalent resistance RS is given by simply by adding the three resistors. We know this one. We have derived this relation for the case of two resistors. Okay. Therefore, RS is equal to simply R1 plus R2 plus R3. They have given the value of these three, 1 plus 2 plus 3. Therefore, the RS is equal to, it is 6 ohms. The equivalent resistance is equal to 6 ohms. Now part B, if the combination is connected to a battery, now this combination is connected to a battery of negligible internal resistance, that here they have given, internal resistance of the battery is negligible or almost zero. Battery of EMF is given, that is 12 volts, EMF of the battery is 12 volts, but internal resistance is zero, negligible, that is given second part. In the part B given, EMF of the battery is given, it is 12 volts. Internal resistance is negligible, we will think it as zero. Then what is the current flowing through the circuit? A circuit alli eshtu current hogta ide work out madbeku. And one more thing they have asked, what is the potential drop across each resistor? That means you have to calculate what is the potential drop across the first resistor. If you take it as V1, that we have to calculate, drop across the second V2 and drop across the third, that is V3, question mark, that we have to work out. Now when the battery is connected, since they have given the internal resistance is zero, there is no potential drop inside the battery. Battery olagade yavade potential drop agodilla, current I flow aagta unto. First we have to work out what is the total current. That is same current. Since they are in series, the same current flows through all the resistors. Therefore, current through the circuit I is equal to, simple expression is there. So, general formula. So, it is E divided by R plus R anta gotunto, capital R plus small r. But here, small r is 0. That is negligible internal resistance anta helidane. So, therefore, I is equal to E divided by, illi mooru resistor irodrinda, I will write it as their equivalent, that is RS. Resistance the equivalent annu baridane. So therefore EMF is 12, equivalent resistance is 6. That means 2 amps of current is flowing in the circuit. A circuit alli 2 amps of current to flow aagtade. Since resistors are in series, the same current flows through all the three resistors. Now we have to calculate what is the potential drop across the first resistor, second and third. Now potential drop, across R1, that is first resistor. Okay. If I take that one as V1, this is equal to I into R1, current multiplied by that particular resistor. Now current is, so 2 amps and the resistance is 1, therefore this 2 volts. Similarly, V2 is equal to I into R2, that is 2 into 2, that is 4 volts. Now V3 is equal to I into R3, that is current is 2 into 3, that is 6 volts. Now voltage drop across each resistor, 2 volts, 4 volts, 6 volts. Now look here, if I add these 3 volts, voltages, I will get 12 volts, which is nothing but the same EMF of the cell. Previous problem only, EMF terminal voltage change it to, EMF 10 volts is to terminal voltage 8.5 bandit to, in that problem we had an internal resistance. But here the internal resistance is negligible. So that means whatever the voltage you are sending, that is 12 volts, it is dropped across the three resistors. You remember this concept. Okay. Next problem, three resistors, 2 ohm, 4 ohm, 5 ohm are combined in parallel. What is the total resistance of the combination? If the combination is connected to a battery of EMF 12 volts and negligible internal resistance, determine the current through each resistor and total current in the circuit. So, three resistors, 2, 4, 5, they are connected in parallel. Let me write that diagram. Now, I have the first resistor, 2 ohm, the second resistor, 4 ohm, the third resistor, 6 ohm. They are connected in parallel, that is end to end. They are connected across two common terminals. Now this is the parallel combination. Now it is 2 ohm, this is 4 ohm and 5 ohm. Okay. What is their effective resistance or equivalent resistance? So given, now if I take the first resistor, R1 is equal to 2 ohm and R2 is equal to 3 ohm and R3 is equal to 2 ohm, R2 it is 4 ohm and it is 5 ohm, 2, 4, 5 ohms. Now we have to calculate R equivalent. Since they are parallel, I will write it as RP. Okay. So when resistors are connected in parallel, the reciprocal of the effective resistance, that is RP, 1 upon RP is equal to sum of the reciprocal of the individual resistances that we have derived earlier. Okay, that is the formula for the parallel combination of resistors. Okay, so 1 upon RP is equal to 1 by 2 plus 1 by 4 plus 1 by 5. Now simplify the right hand side. Now 2, 4 and 5, their LCM is 20. So therefore it is 10 plus 5 plus 4. So therefore this one is equal to 19 by 20. This is 1 upon RP. It is 1 upon RP. 1 by 2, 1 by 4, 1 by 5. Okay. Therefore, what is RP? Now, RP we want. So, that is equal to 20 by 19 ohms. 20 by 19 ohms equivalent resistance. Now, this combination, part B, if the combination is connected to a battery of EMF 12 volts. Now, it is connected to a battery of EMF 12 volts. Of negligible internal resistance connected to a battery of 12 volts. Now small r is 0, negligible internal resistance of the head between. So therefore for the second case, the EMF is 12 volts and small r value is 0, internal resistance is negligible. Then you have to calculate what is the current through each branch, that is I1, current through the first resistor, I2, the current through the second resistor, I3, current through the third resistor, and also the total current in the circuit, that we are going to determine. Okay. Now, in the case of parallel combination, we know that whatever the voltage is applied, the same voltage is dropped across the three resistors. That means the voltage drop across the 2 ohm, 4 ohm and 5 ohm remains the same, that is the EMF 12 volts agide head. From that relation we can calculate what is I1, what is I2, I3 and hence the total current. Therefore current, since V is equal to 12 volts across each resistor because it is parallel combination. Therefore, current through the first resistor I1. How can you find the current? Current I1 is equal to, it is V divided by R1 by using Ohm's law. Current I1 is equal to V divided by R1. V is 12 divided by R1 is 2. So 12 by 2, that is 6 amps. Now this amount of current is flowing in the first. Now this is, if I write it as I1 and I2, if I take it as I3. Now here it is I. Current is flowing in the circuit, total current. Now similarly, the current flowing through the second resistor, that is I2, is equal to, it is V by R2. V by R2, so V is 12 divided by 4, that is 3 amps. 3 amps of current to flow up by the head. And I3, I3, so it is V by R3, that is 12 divided by 5, 12 divided by 5, so it is equal to 2.4 amps. 12 by 5 is 2.4 amps. Now these are the branch current, current through individual resistors. Then total current. Now this can be calculated in two ways. One is by using the junction rule at this point. The point only junction rule and apply madre. The current entering is I, that is total current, and the current leaving are I1 plus I2 plus I3. By that junction rule, I is equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3. So adding them, that is 6 plus 3 plus 2.4. Therefore, I is equal to 11.4 amps. This is one method of determining the total current. The another method of determining the total current is, I will do here. Total current I is equal to the voltage or EMF applied divided by the equivalent resistance RP. Voltage applied divided by the equivalent resistance. From that term also we can calculate the total current. So this is 12 divided by RP that you have calculated. This is 12 into 19 by 20. From the this one also you can calculate this one. Now obviously nearly 19 means nearly equal to 20 and further. So we are getting the same value of current, that is 11.4 amps. Both are same. Eritrithiyalu now calculation maadabahudu. Next problem. At room temperature, that is 27 degrees Celsius, the resistance of a heating element is 100 ohm. What is the temperature of the element if the resistance is found to be 117 ohms? Given the temperature coefficient of material of the resistor, alpha is equal to 1.70 into 10 to the power of minus 4 per degree Celsius. So solution, a very simple problem here. At room temperature, that is if I take that as temperature at a T1, at a temperature T1, that is 27 degrees Celsius, what is the resistance of the wire? It is 100 ohm. Now I take it as R1 is equal to 100 ohms. Next we have to calculate what is the temperature, that is higher temperature T2, at which the resistance R2 is equal to, that is given, resistance becomes 117 ohms agbekadre, what is the rise in temperature? And temperature coefficient of material of the resistor is given, it is 1.70 into 10 to the power of minus 4 per degree Celsius. Now these are the given things. We know that the variation of resistivity or resistance, so since here they have asked resistance, we can have the formula, resistance R2 is equal to, it is R1 into 1 plus alpha into T2 minus T1. This is the formula. This is the general formula. We have used for the case of resistivity, rho t is equal to rho naught into 1 plus alpha into t minus t naught, that we have used. Now we have modified this one for the case of a resistor, R2 is equal to R1 into 1 plus alpha into T2 minus T1. Now from this expression we are going to calculate what is T2. So T2 we have to find out. Now let me simplify this one. Now R2 is equal to R1 plus R1 alpha T2 minus T1, or R2 minus R1 is equal to R1 alpha T2 minus T1. Okay, simplify martta hodre. So I want this one only. Therefore, R2 minus R1 divided by R1 alpha is T2 minus T1. Now first we will work out this one. Idan work out maduva, amele find out maduva. Okay. Therefore, let me write here. T2 minus T1 is equal to R2 minus R1 divided by R1 into alpha. Okay. And they have given the value of R2 and R1. R2 is 117. R1 is 100 divided by R1 is once again 100 into alpha, temperature coefficient of variation, that is 1.7 into 10 to the power of minus 4, 1.7 into 10 to the power of minus 4, that we have substituted. Now simplify this one. Once this becomes 17 by 100 into 1.7 into 10 to the power of minus 4. Okay, so simple calculation is there. Work out moduva. So 1s are 10s are, so it is 1s are 10s are, so I am getting T2 minus T1 is equal to, so 10 to the power of minus 4, 10 to the power of plus 1, therefore it is 10 to the power of minus 3, 10 to the power of minus 4, 10 to the power of plus 1, it is 10 to the power of minus 3 in the denominator. If I take it to the numerator, it is 10 to the power of plus 3. Therefore, T2 minus T1 is equal to 10 to the power of plus 3 is 1000. Therefore, T2 is equal to T1 plus 1000, T1 is 27 plus 1000, therefore T2 is equal to 1027 degrees Celsius, 1027 degrees Celsius, yes. Next problem, a negligibly small current is passed through a wire of length 15 meter and uniform cross section 6.0 into 10 to the power of minus 7 meter square, and its resistance is measured to be 5 ohm. What is the resistivity of the material at the temperature of the experiment? So 15 meter wire cross sectional area 6 into 10 to the power of minus 7 is there, and the resistance 5 ohm is there. What is the resistivity? Resistivity is to work out. Very simple is that. So solution given. Length of the wire is given. It is 15 meter. Okay. And uniform cross sectional area of the wire. Area of the wire is given. That is 6.0 into 10 raised to minus 7 meter square. Area of cross section. And resistance of the wire is given. Resistance is 5.0 ohms. We have to work out what is resistivity. So we have defined resistivity. It is the resistance of the wire of unit area and unit length. Unit length and unit area of cross section. That we have known. Now we know that the resistance R is equal to rho into L divided by A. Simple formula. Now from that formula, what is resistivity? Therefore, rho is equal to Ra divided by L. So simple formula is that. So substitute the values and work out. It is 5.0 and area of cross section is 6.0 into 10 raised to minus 7, okay, divided by length, it is 15 meter. All are in SI unit. Okay. So this is 5 ones are, 3 is a, 3 ones are, 3 twos are. So therefore, resistivity is equal to 2 into 10 to the power of minus 7. 2 into 10 to the power of minus 7. What is the unit? Ohm meter. 2 into 10 to the power of minus 7. Ohm meter is the resistivity of the given material at the room temperature or temperature of the experiment. Next problem. A silver wire has a resistance of 2.1 ohm at 27.5 degrees Celsius and a resistance of 2.7 ohm at 100 degrees Celsius. Now determine the temperature coefficient of resistivity of silver. So simple problem put it on. So here are different temperatures only. What is the resistance of the silver wire? Then you have to work out what is the alpha value, temperature coefficient of resistivity. So we will work out solution. So given, so initially R1 is given, resistance at one temperature, that is R1 is equal to, if I take it as 2.1 ohm, it is at a temperature T1, that is 27.5 degree Celsius, 27.5 degree Celsius. Okay, and R2 is given, that is 2.7 ohm at a temperature of 100 degree, that is T2. So T2 is equal to 100 degree Celsius. If this is the case, what you are going to calculate? The temperature coefficient of resistance or resistivity, both are same here. Alpha we have to calculate. We know the simple relation. Now R2 is equal to R1 into 1 plus alpha into T2 minus T1. 1 plus alpha into T2 minus T1. Now from this formula, so we can write for alpha is equal to R1 plus R1 alpha into T2 minus T1. R2 minus R1 is equal to R1 alpha T2 minus T1. Or from this relation, what is alpha? Alpha is equal to R2 minus R1 divided by R1 into T2 minus T1. We can directly remember this formula. We can directly remember this formula. Therefore, alpha is equal to R2 minus R1 divided by R1 into T2 minus T1. Now substitute the all the known values and simplify it. Now R2, it is 2.7 minus R1 is 2.7 minus 2.1 divided by R1, it is 2.1 T2 minus T1. T2 is 100. T1 is 27.5 degrees Celsius. So we will simplify this one. 2.7 minus 2.1, it is 0.6 divided by 2.1 into 100 minus 27.5, it is 72.5. If I use the calculator and work out what is the value, 0.6 divided by 2.1 divided by 72, 0.6 divided by 2.1 divided by 72.5, that is equal to 0.0039 unit is per degree Celsius, value of alpha 0.0039 per degree Celsius, temperature coefficient of resistance or resistivity, we can call both. Next problem, a heating element using nichrome connected to a 230 volt supply. Draws an initial current of 3.2 amps when settles, after which settles after a few seconds to a steady value of 2.8 amps. What is the steady temperature of the heating element if the room temperature is 27 degrees Celsius? Given alpha value, temperature coefficient of resistance of that nichrome wire is averaged for a room temperature range 1.70 × 10⁻⁴ degree per degree Celsius. ಒಂದು ನೈಕ್ರೋಮ್ ವೈರ್ ಇದೆ ರೂಮ್ ಟೆಂಪರೇಚರ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ, ಅದನ್ನ ಬ್ಯಾಟರಿ ಕನೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಕರೆಂಟು 3.2 amps ಹೋಗ್ತಾ ಇರ್ತದೆ. 230 volt ಕನೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ ಇನಿಷಿಯಲ್ ಆಗಿ 3.2 ಬರ್ತದೆ. ದೆನ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಸಮ್ ಫ್ಯೂ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ಸ್, ಸಮ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ಸ್ ಆದ್ಮೇಲೆ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಏನಾಗ್ತದೆ 2.8 ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ. 3.2 ಇನಿಷಿಯಲ್ ಹೋಗ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದದ್ದು 2.8 ಆಯ್ತು. ಯಾಕಿರ್ಬೋದು? ಸಿನ್ಸ್ ದ ವೈರ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಎ ಸರ್ಟನ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್, ಇನಿಷಿಯಲ್ ಆಗಿ 3.2 ಇತ್ತು. ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ದ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಫ್ಲೋಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಎ ಫ್ಯೂ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ಸ್ ದ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಗೆಟ್ಸ್ ಹೀಟ್ಸ್ ಅಪ್, ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಹೀಟ್ ಅಪ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ಸೊ ದೇರ್ ಫಾರ್ ಆಬ್ವಿಯಸ್ಲಿ ಏನಾಗ್ತದೆ, ಸೊ ಟೆಂಪರೇಚರ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ಸೊ ಟೆಂಪರೇಚರ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಆಗೋಯ್ತು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ರಿಡ್ಯೂಸಸ್, ಟೆಂಪರೇಚರ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸಸ್, ದೇರ್ ಫಾರ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸಸ್, ದೇರ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಆಬ್ವಿಯಸ್ಲಿ ರಿಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಆಗಿ 2.8 amps ಗೆ ಸ್ಟಡಿ ರೇಟ್ ಗೆ ಬಂದು ನಿಲ್ತದೆ. ದೆನ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಅಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ಟೆಂಪರೇಚರ್ ಇಟ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ಸ್ 2.8 amps ಆಫ್ ಕರೆಂಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಸೊಲ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಗಿವನ್ ನಾವು ಆರ್ ಒನ್ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ವಿ ಬೈ ಐ ಐ, ಐ ಐ ಇಸ್ ದ ಇನಿಷಿಯಲ್ ಕರೆಂಟ್, ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು 230 divided by initial current is 3.2. If I calculate this one, I will get 71.875 ohms. It is at a initial temperature of T1 is equal to room temperature anta heltane, that is 27.0 degree Celsius. Okay, R1. Then R2 we can calculate, that is V by I final current, I final current, that is V is 230, voltage remains the same, current decreases, 3.2 is the same, it is 2.8, I will work out. So 230 divided by 2.8. So that is equal to 82.143 ohms. Now at what temperature that we are going to calculate? We have to calculate the final temperature at which the current becomes steady. That is 3.2 decrease agta agta bando 2.8 ge steady agtane. Yav temperature alli avanu 2.8 ge steady agtane annadanna work out madbeku. And they have given the temperature coefficient of resistance of that wire is 1.70 into, so 10⁻⁴ per degree Celsius. Now these are the given data and we have to calculate what is T2. Now simple formula we are having. Now R2 is equal to R1 into 1 plus alpha into T2 minus T1. This is the formula. ಸೊ ಇದನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ಟರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನ ರಿಅರೇಂಜ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡು ಪ್ರೀವಿಯಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಬರೆದಿದ್ವಿ. ದೆರ್ಫೋರ್ T2 ಮೈನಸ್ T1 ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಏನಾಗ್ತದೆ ಹೇಳಿ, ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ R2 ಮೈನಸ್ R1 ಡಿವೈಡ್ ಬೈ R1 ಇಂಟು ಆಲ್ಫಾ, R1 ಇಂಟು ಆಲ್ಫಾ, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾ. ಸೊ ಇದನ್ನ ರಿಅರೇಂಜ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡು ಸಿಂಪ್ಲಿಫೈ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ವಿಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ R2 ಮೈನಸ್ R1 ಡಿವೈಡ್ ಬೈ R1 ಇಂಟು ಆಲ್ಫಾ. ದೆರ್ಫೋರ್ T2 ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು T1 plus R2 minus R1 divided by R1 alpha. Work out madva. So T1 is 27 plus R2. This is 82.143 minus R1, this is 71.875 divided by R1 into alpha. R1, it is 71.875 into alpha is given 1.70 into 10 to the power of minus 4. Okay. Therefore, T2 is equal to, if you calculate this one with the calculator, you will get 840.35 plus 27. Therefore, T2 is equal to 867.35 degree Celsius. 867.35 degree Celsius. Our temperature alli current enagutade steady birthane, birthane. That is 2.8 amps ge reduced aagutade heli. Okay. Okay. Next problem. Determine the current in each branch of the following network. They have given this network, Wheatstone bridge network. The various resistors are, 5 resistors are connected like this, and AC is called the battery arm because we have connected a 10 volts and 10 ohm internal resistance battery. Across BD, assume that a galvanometer of 5 ohm resistance is connected. Assume like that. Now we have to calculate what is the branch current, what is the current through each arm. Now if I is the main current flowing in the circuit, then I1 is the current flowing along AB and I2 is flowing along AD. We have taken like that. Okay. At the junction B, the I1 current divides. Now let me take the current flowing through BD is I3. If the current flowing through BD is I3, then according to the junction rule, what is the current flowing through along BC? So it is I1 minus I3. It becomes I1 bartha ide illi I2 I3 hogta idane hagagare ee remaining point alli remaining junction alli it is I1 minus I3 is flowing. Now at the junction D, I2 is entering and I3 is entering. Therefore along BC the current should leave, it should leave the junction. Okay, it is not supposed to enter according to the junction rule. So therefore the current along DC is I2 plus I3. Now if you look at this C, at the junction C, these two currents are entering, therefore I1 minus I3, I2 plus I3. So minus I3 plus I3 it cancels, it becomes I1 plus I2. So I1 plus I2 is nothing but I. So at the junction C also I1 plus I2 entering, therefore I total current I is leaving. Now these are the various branch currents. Now let me solve this one solution from this point here itself. Okay. Now we have to apply Kirchhoff's loop rule for the three different loops. Now is the first loop and second and third. Now choose your direction of traverse. I am choosing the direction of traverse like this. Now let me consider the first loop. For the loop, which one? Start from A, D, C, E, A. So A, D, C, E, A. Now applying Kirchhoff loop rule. The Kirchhoff loop rule. So now look here. Current is flowing from A to D and the direction of traverse is A to D, that IR product is negative. Therefore, I will write it is minus 5 I2 in this branch. Okay. Now look here at the point DC. At the point DC. So direction of traverse and current are in the same direction. Therefore, that IR product is negative. That is 10 into I2 plus I3. Clear? Now if you come across this here, we are having another resistor. If you assume that it is an internal resistance of the cell, the current flowing and the direction of traverse are same, therefore it is minus 10 I, it is minus 10, I, total current, I is flowing. That minus 10 I is nothing but same as I1 plus I2. From this one, at this junction, I is equal to I1 plus I2, that we can write. That way I will write it in the next step. Now these are the three resistors. And in the cell, the direction of current and the traverse are same. So therefore it is plus 10 is equal to 0. Clear? Now at the junction A, at A, now I is equal to, what is the current entering? So that is equal to I1 plus I2. So that I will substitute here. Now therefore, minus 5 I2 minus 10 I2 plus I3 minus 10 I1 plus I2 plus 10, I will send it to the another on the right hand side, it becomes minus 10. Just to simplify it, minus 5 I2 minus 10 I2 minus 10 I3 minus 10 I1 minus 10 I2. So we are getting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 terms. That should be equal to minus 10. That should be equal to minus 10. Now simplify. Now I am having 10 I1, minus 10 I1 first. So in minus 10 I1, now come across I2. Now I2 here is, I am having I2, here one more I2, and here is 3 I2s are there. That is minus 10, minus 10, minus 5. It is minus 25 I2, minus 25 I2, okay. And minus 10 I3 is equal to minus 10. Now carefully look here. So here 5 is common in all the terms. Divide throughout by minus 5. So dividing by minus 5. Minus 5 in the now divide matter. What I am going to get? 2i1 plus 5i2 plus 2i3 is equal to 2. Call this as equation 1. Similarly, applying for the second loop, applying Kirchhoff loop rule for the second loop, A, B, D, A. Okay. Now, along A, B, current and traverse are in the same. That IR product is negative 10 I1. Along B, D, both are in the same direction. IR product is negative minus 5 I3. But in along A, D, direction of traverse and the current flowing from this one, direction of traverse and current flowing are in opposite direction, therefore that IR product is positive plus 5 I2, since there is no EMF, is equal to 0. Now dividing throughout by minus 5, I will get plus 2 I1 plus I3 minus I2 is equal to 0. Rearranging these two terms, I will get 2I1 minus I2 plus I3 is equal to 0. Call this as equation 2. Clear? Similarly, apply for the third branch, third loop. For the loop B, C, D, B. B, C, D, B. So here along BC, direction of current and traverse are same. Therefore, the IR product is negative I1 minus I3. Along CD, current and the direction of traverse are in opposite direction. Therefore, it is positive plus, it is 10 into I2 plus I3. And in the third branch, that is along BD, both are in opposite direction. Current flowing and traverse are in opposite, therefore that product is positive, is equal to 0. Okay. Now simplifying this one, minus 5 I1 plus 5 I3 plus 10 I2 plus 10 i3 plus 5 i3 is equal to 0. Now i1 is only one term, minus 5 i1. Now i2, 10 i2, only one term, plus 10 i2. Look at i3, plus 5 i3, 10 i3, plus 5, that is 20. 20 i3 is equal to 0. Once again dividing by minus 5, we get i1 minus 2 i2 minus 4 i3 is equal to 0. Call this as equation 3. Okay, we are getting three simultaneous equations. This is the one, second, and third. From these three equations, we solve for i1, i2, and i3. Okay. Now look here, the three equations. Now here we have 2i1 and 2i1. By subtracting 1 and minus 2. So 1 minus 2, equation 1 minus equation 2 gives. Now this i1 gets cancelled. Therefore, equation 1 minus equation 2. Now subtract here. So 2i1 minus 2i1, it cancels. 5i1 minus half minus plus 5i2 minus half minus plus i2. Therefore, it becomes 6i2, 2i3 minus i3. Therefore, it is minus plus i3. 6i2 plus i3 is equal to 2. Call this as equation 4. You have got equation 4. Now, similarly, equation 2 minus 2 times the equation 3. That means multiply equation 3 by 2 and subtract from this equation 2. Okay. So equation 2 minus 2 into equation 3. Okay. Let me write that one. Equation 2 is 2i1 minus i2 plus i3 is equal to 0. Now multiply the equation 3 by 2, I will get 2i1 minus 4i2 minus 8i3 is equal to 0. Now subtracting here, now minus plus plus. Now these two get cancels. 4 minus 1, that is 3i2 plus 9i3 is equal to 0. Call this as equation 5. Call that as equation 5. Now from 4 and 5, eliminate i2. How can you eliminate? That is equation 4 minus 2 into equation 5. So by multiplying equation 5 by 2 and subtracting, I will get 6i2 plus i3 is equal to 2. Now multiplying this expression by 2, therefore 6i2 plus 18i3 is equal to 0. Now subtracting this one, minus, minus. Now 6i2 minus 6i2 get cancels. Minus 18 plus 1, that is minus 17i3 is equal to 2. Therefore, we get the current i3 is equal to minus 2 by 17 amps. We have got i3 current. I3 is this much, minus 2 by 17. Now substitute this value in either of the equation, either 4 or 5. Let me take equation 5. From equation 5. So 3i2 is equal to plus 9i3 akade hodre enagtade, minus 9i3 aagtade. Therefore i2 is equal to minus 3i3. Okay. Now substitute for i3. So you will get minus 3 into i3 is minus 2 by 17. Therefore, we got i2 is equal to plus 6 by 17 amps. So i2 is equal to plus 6 by 17 amps. That one we are getting. We have got i3 and i2. Now substituting these two values in any one of the equations, in any one of the first three equations, we will get i1. Now I will take the third equation, I will write here. From the third equation, equation 3, Okay. Now this is I1. Now I am sending these two terms to the right hand side. Therefore, this becomes is equal to plus 2I2 plus 4I3 plus 2I2 plus 4I3. So therefore, 2 into what is I2? It is 6 by 17. 6 by 17 plus 4 into what is I3? What is I3? So I3 is minus of 2 by 17. So therefore is equal to 12 by 17 minus 8 by 17. Therefore current I1 is equal to 12 minus 8. This is 4 by 17 amps. So we have got I1, I2 and I3. So from this we can easily work out what is the current flowing in each branches. So if you want I, add all the three. Here it is I1 flowing, here it is I2, here it is I3. Now here it is I1 minus I3. I1 minus I3 subtract madre current flowing through BC sigtade. Hage I2 plus I3 add madre current along DC namge sigtade. Clear?